Okay, this piece is in the key of D. I'm going to show you a D major scale. Let's extend it on up the E string. Low second here. Up to the fourth. Back down. High second here. Here are the fingers for the A part. Start on F sharp, first finger on the E string. Walk down, open E, D, third finger on the A. Now skip to B. Let's do it again. Repeat the B. Next part starts the same, different ending. Skip to open A. Two of them. Next phrase. Back up to F sharp. A. Third finger on the E. Walk down, starting with the low second finger. And back up to F sharp. Start over. B. A. Back up to F sharp and up to A. Walk down. Low second. Now we have a chromatic. You're going to play that second finger high like usual. And now slide it down to the low second finger position right next to the first finger. And that's called a chromatic walk down. All right, let's do the whole thing here. Chromatic walk down. Okay, let's add a hammer on. It's going to come here. You're just going to hammer on from open A to that first B. Here we go. Two, three. Hammer on. One more time. Let's add some drones. Drone your open D here. Again. Carry on. Drone open D and open A. Next one, we're going to use the high second finger on the A string, C sharp, and we're going to pair it with that A third finger on the E. So so that's what it's going to sound like. Here we go. Put them both down. Again. Now you're going to use the low second finger. You're going to shift that finger from this position to this position for the walk down. And drone your open A here. Or you can drone your third finger, D. All right, let's repeat that. Open A and D. Second on A. Low second. And here's your second ending. Here's what it's going to look like. I'll just demonstrate for a minute. So here's how you're going to do your chromatics now. You're going to put F sharp down on the D string, tune it to your open A. Third finger on the A string right next to it. That'll be your first note. Lift your third finger. Slide that second finger over to the A string for C sharp. That'll be your second note, just the fifth. Second finger mashes down on both notes. Now, you're going to slide that second finger down on the A string, as we did before, to right next to the first. You're going to swing your left elbow underneath the fiddle toward your center of your body and place the third finger now where the second was on that F sharp on the D string. So you get that tritone. All right, let's do that again. Start like this. That in tune. Lift your third finger, second finger on both strings. Slide the second finger down. Rock the elbow. Third finger where the second finger was. One last time. So let's put that whole thing together. Now we've got the A part. Let's put some slides in. Slide up to that first note, F sharp. Hammer on here. Slide into the F sharp on the repeat. Same as before. And you can drone on these pickup notes, by the way. If you like, just play the next lower open string. Now, you can slide into this double stop if you want. Let's just try that last phrase again. All these slides are optional. You can mix and match as you please. You can slide into the G if you want. You can slide into these. Or not, as you please. Starting over, taking the repeat. That slide again. Slide. These are just playing. So let's do that whole A section again. Here we go. One, two, three. Thank you. using a lot of long bows on this. We have a lot of long notes, and the tendency is not to hold them out long enough. So you want to be real honest with these long notes and make sure that you do that. If you haven't reviewed the section or looked at the section on long bowing right now, go ahead and take a moment to do so, please, and learn how to make nice, long, smooth bows and bow changes. Section for now, and you probably noticed that every phrase had two long bows at the end, down and up. For the pickup notes, we're going to start down for the first pickup note and take the second two pickup notes in an up bow slur. So let's try that together. Up. Here come your long bows. Next set of pickups. Down, up. Here come your next long notes. Down, up. And they're all the same. It's the same pattern for the whole section. Till you get to the end. Down and up. Up. Down and up. Here. Down, up, down. Got it? Let's put it all together. Two, three. Start the next part down bow. Here's the part you've been waiting for. All right, we're going to break this cross shuffle down. First of all, you're going to be doing a lot of string crossings between the A and E strings. So let's get the motion just for the string crossing. We're not going to worry about that exact bowing right now. We're just going to get the motion for the crossing between the two strings, your two upper strings. Position your bow so that it's evenly on both. Play your A string on a down bow. And now dip, lower your arm, your upper arm, to dip over to the E and scoop it on an up bow. Let's just do that a bunch. We're going to use the arm now to make circles with the bow. Can you see how the frog right here is making circles? Or ellipses. All right, let's do it backwards. Up bow on the E. No, down bow on the E. So now you've got counterclockwise circles. Because this is in three, in groups of threes, you're going to have them both ways, clockwise and counterclockwise. So you want to get your arm real comfortable and moving both those directions. You can also do this with your forearm. Down on the A, up on the E, circles with the forearm. These will be clockwise circles. Down, up. And you can practice them the other way, counterclockwise circles. Up on the A, down on the E. Can you see my forearm is doing the work here? My upper arm is moving passively. If you want a nice smooth sound on these, it's good to let your wrists and fingers be nice and loose too. You can use your upper arm, you can use your forearm, you can use any combination, but just make sure everything's nice and loose and fluid. Here we go. Down on the A, up on the E. The other way. Up on the A, down on the E. Okay. That's your preliminary. Now we're going to do these in threes. We're going to do five sets of three, and then we're going to, let me show you. One, two. Notice your bowing reversed. Three, four, and five. And the last one, we're going to take an extra up bow on that open A for a total of 16 notes. That's going to take up two measures or four measures, depending upon whether you're thinking eighth notes or 16th notes. Anyway, it all works out to an even number, and that's how the cross shuffle works. So let's try this again. Open strings, A and E. Set your bow on both strings to get it centered, and then just rock it very slightly over to the A. It doesn't need to be a big motion here. And very slightly over to the E. Here we go. Five sets of three plus one extra. And here's the extra. All right. Now's the acid test. We're going to put this with the metronome. Okay, let's try that a couple more times. Your first finger on the A string on B, and put your second finger down on the E string on G natural. Remember that second finger is right close to the first. Okay, the next sequence will be open A and F sharp. You're just going to slide that first finger directly across. Next, open A and E. Back to the previous one. A and F sharp. Repeat. Start with B and G. First and low second. Open A and first on the E. And I'll give you a simple ending first. All right. How that goes, you have your low second finger on the A string right next to the first. Not the usual position up here, but you're going to take it back a half a step. And you're going to slide it up to high second finger. Let's try that again. C sharp, C natural to C sharp. And one more time. Now place your A, third finger, on the E string right next to it. So that's going to look like this. Again. One last time. Move that second finger down to the low position now and place it on the E string for G natural. Walk down. Do that again. G, F sharp, and walk all the way down to D. So that sequence again, starting from C natural, low second on the A. Walk down, low second. All right, so let's get real clear on the fingers for the B part now. Slide. You're going to put your first finger on the A and the second on the E for that first one. Here we go. Five sets of three, one extra. Next one, open A, F sharp on the E string. Here we go. Again. Give your left hand a break. Open strings. To the last one you did, open A, first on the E. Start over with these two. Open A and first finger. Okay, hold on a second now. We're going to do it with the metronome. Mr. Metronome keeps us honest. Change. talking about these in terms of groups of three. Now we're going to talk about them in terms of groups of four, just to make life complicated. What we're dealing with is a hemiola. In this case, it's not a medical condition. Don't worry. In this case, it's patterns of three notes over groups of four. In terms of your timing, it's 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4. But as we just practiced, we're practicing 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3. So we're going to look at it in terms of groups of four. Because we've got the threes, it's going to regress, and I'll show you what I mean by that. Put your finger down first on the A, low second on the E, and we'll do it over that G chord. First group of four notes is going to sound like this. Now you notice the high note is on the third of the fourth four notes. One, two, high note here on three, four, one more time. Because it's a regressing pattern, the next time it's going to occur on the second note of the group of four. Again. On the third group of four, it's going to occur on the first one. And also on the last one. So that third one looks like a smile with the high note on either end. And the fourth group is like the first. Are you thoroughly confused now? Let's try this again. First group. High note's going to fall on the third note. Second group. High note's going to fall on the second note. Third group. High note falls on the first note. Fourth group, like the first. Let's put it all together. No stops. And with our friend the metronome. If you practice this and you get this down, you are going to be so rock solid on the cross shuffle. You're going to impress everybody. Again. We're going to apply that pattern now to all of them. Pause it. Take your time with this. Don't expect to get it in one sitting. It'll take a while. Be patient with yourself. So you took a break and now you're going, right? Okay, but I know you're saying, wait a minute, that's not the whole thing. She's not really giving me the whole thing. That's not what it sounds like. You want, right? And then you're going to want, okay. We're going to do the cross shuffle now with the top note alternating. Here's what it's going to look like. Thank you. Here's how we're going to do it. You're going to put your fingers on the A and E strings like you had them before. Low second on the E, regular first on the A. And we're going to go like this. Third finger on the E now. Back to second. Third. Second. Okay, let's try that again. Here we go. Are we having fun yet? Let's try that again. Take the next pattern. Do the same thing with the low second finger. Again. Time. Open strings. First. Once again. All together. Do it all again, taking the second ending. So, down, up, down, up, down. Let's do it again. Down, up, down, up, down. Change fingers. Open A first on the E. First on the E and low second. Up. Down. Up. You got those open strings now, alternating with first on the E. Back to to the last one, first and second on the E. Down. The whole thing with the second ending. Really scoop those high notes. Home free, second ending. Put it all together. To the cross shuffle. We're going to drone open D here. Same here, open D. Now our open D is not going to work with this next one because we're playing an A chord, so you're just going to be on the A and the E as before. Down when you hit the A. You can drone open A on your walk down. And on your final note, you can drone open D or F sharp. That fancy bluegrassy ending. We're going to start with low second finger on the A like we did for the simple ending and slide it up to high second and then rock the bow over to A on the E string, and then we're going to repeat it. We're going to go to F natural, low first on the E string, slide it up to F sharp, high first. Let's try it again. A, third finger on the E. Skip back down to F sharp. Slide back down to F natural. Open E, D, that's three on the A, one on the A, B, and on three on the A. Let's put it all together now. C natural. Three, four. I'm going to loop it a couple of times for you. Sharp drone at the end if you like. Here's the bowing for that fancy ending. Notice that three-note lick has a different rhythm the second time. So you need a nice long bow there. So you're going to start down. So down, scoop, down again. And this is a very long note. Let's do it without the metronome. Down, up, down, up. And the next part, you're going to slur that F natural to F sharp first on the E in one down bow. You're going to take all these other notes in an up bow slur. Let's try those. Starting on A. It'll go fast and you'll have enough bow. A, F sharp, F natural, E, D, B. Ready? Again. One last time. For your final note on a nice emphatic down bow. So putting it all together. C natural to C sharp. Three, four. Let's try it with the metronome. Here we go. Dolly with our constant companion, the metronome.